This moment is believed to be one of the funniest bloopers in World Cup history. But in reality, it's a dark tale about regimes, soccer and protest. So, how did we get here? Let's go back to the Congo crisis. After 5 years of coups and rebellions, a ruthless dictator took power in 1965. Mobutu had a great investment in the squad, using their success as a way to improve his reputation and distract the world from his crimes. By winning the African Cup of Nations in 1974, Zaire earned a trip to Germany for the most prized trophy of them all, the World Cup. Unfortunately, Zaire was drawn into a tough group. After that 2-0 defeat to Scotland, the players learned they would not be getting paid, as Mobutu's entourage had completely run their funds dry. Demoralized, the squad trudged onto the pitch to play Yugoslavia. The game quickly turned into a rout. Mobutu was fuming. With his nation now a laughingstock, he threatened the team. If you lose 4-0 to Brazil, you will not be allowed to come home. Down 2-0, Brazil earned a free kick about 25 yards out. If Zaire concedes, fear would truly sink in. That's Mwempulunga, one of the most vocal members of the Zaire squad. In one final act of protest, he sends a large middle finger back to Mobutu. This was not a blooper. This was a dangerous protest against a cruel leader and an attempt to waste time in order to see his friends and family again. Eventually, the match would finish 3-0. After returning home and facing punishment from Mobutu, Lunga would continue to work for the national team until he passed away in 2015. His loss was greatly mourned by the Congo soccer community.